Maximal matchings are a useful tool for getting a coarsened graph. All we need now is an algorithm to compute one. Let me describe a simple scheme to you based on randomization. At each step of this scheme, you'll choose any unmatched vertex at random. So initially, no edges are matched, so let's pick any vertex. How about this one? Next, you'll match this vertex to one of its unmatched neighbors. Again, since we're just starting, all of the neighbors are unmatched. So how do we pick one? Well, there are lots of strategies. For example, you could just pick one at random. A different approach is something called a heavy edge matching strategy.
So heavy, so heavy.
The idea is to look at the unmatched edge with the highest weight and then choose it. For instance, suppose these are the edge weights. Then among the two unmatched neighbors, this edge has the higher edge weight, 2 versus 1. So you'd choose it. But why is the heavy edge matching strategy a good one? In fact, there's not a whole lot of definitive, rigorous analysis out there, but there is a lot of experimental evidence. What I want to do now is just give you some informal intuition. Consider some graph G sub I. Suppose we were to match these two edges. Contracting them would yield a coarsened graph. Let's call it G sub I plus 1. Note the edge weight of 2 that connects the two supervertices. Now, if you were to sum the edge weights in the original graph, you'd get 12. That's because there are 12 edges, each of unit weight. Here, let me use the notation capital X of some object to count the number of edges in that object. Now, the sum of the weights on the final graph is 10. This is just the total edge weight of the original graph minus the edge weight of the matched edges. Here, let M sub I denote the matching. Now, the strategy of selecting heavy edges will tend to try to increase this factor. And if this factor is bigger, then this factor will be smaller. In other words, the heavy edge heuristic is really about increasing this term in order to decrease the overall edge weight in the next graph. The heuristic idea is that the smaller this term is, the more likely it is that all the edges you'll cut will be small. Again, this is clearly not a rigorous proof. In fact, there are a ton of other heuristics, but most of the evidence is empirical. Anyway, if this is a topic of interest to you, head to the instructor's notes or the class forum for pointers to papers that will discuss all these issues in a lot of detail.